gentlemen, just one of the many dream matches, part of Wrestlerock 86. The fabulous ones against the former WWF Tag Team Champions, Mike Rotunda and Barry Wyndham. And Mike, first off, to be just a part of this tremendous day, you and Barry, one of the dream matches promoters all throughout the world wanted to see.
You know, it's a great pleasure to be here tonight. And we're gonna go in there and do our job like we know we can do it. The fabulous ones have been around the world. They know what they're doing too. But Barry and I, like they said, we've had a few titles of our own, and we're here to prove to the Minneapolis and the fans on this great card what we can do.
Well, Barry, without a doubt, the pressure's got to be on in this match. Two of the greatest tag teams ever put together. The winner of this one certainly in prime contention for any tag team title anywhere.
That's right. You know, the AWA has the greatest wrestling wrestlers in the whole world. And that's what we're here for. We came here to get this title, whatever championship they have as a tag. And we're going to show it by beating the fabulous ones right now.
All right, it's coming up, the fabulous ones against Mike Rotunda and Barry Wyndham, all part of Wrestlerock 86.
Well, this one will be a dandy for sure. Not that they all haven't been and will continue to be. But the former champions with a weight advantage, but not a great deal. 492 is their combined weight. 475, the fabulous ones. Mike Rotunda and Barry Wyndham are the former WWF kingpins. The fabulous ones, of course, no stranger to the Midwest or any part of the world. Stan Lane and Steve Kearns. The referee talking with Steve Kearns. Just stay close, everybody. There's the bell. Timekeeper at the bell. Dick Jankowski. And it's Stan Lane in with Barry Wyndham. Wyndham out of Sweetwater, Texas. Lane with the first advantage, but not a big one. And the hold is broken. These fabulous ones, they work very, very quick, and the referee really has to keep his eyes upon them at all times. They look so very, very much alike. A little bit of a stare down there between Stan Lane and Barry Wyndham. Steve Kearns shouting to the referee. Again to the ropes they go. Lane on Wyndham. Wyndham shoving Lane away a bit more forcefully, probably, than Stan particularly liked. The two of them stay in there. Barry Wyndham, Stan Lane, side headlock. Wyndham. One thing about Wyndham and Rotunda, they have a weight advantage, as we told you, but they're also considerably taller than Lane and Kearns. Okay, there they go. Action, fast and furious. Oh, a hard shoulder block. Wyndham on Lane. Around they go. Lane goes. Oh! Lane was ready to pop him over with both legs and took a pop in the forehead himself. Nice work by Barry Wyndham. Lane had him set up just exactly where he wanted it. But it didn't work out exactly the way he wanted it to. The roughest, the toughest, the meanest, the most scientific, the most popular, flat-out, very best wrestlers in the world. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Right here in the AWA. And now Stan Lane with an arm bar, and he works it into a twist, grinds away. Reversal here by Barry Wyndham. Tags in his partner, Rotunda, who comes crashing down on that left arm with an elbow of his own, and a fireman's carry, monkey flip over. Hammerlock now with Mike Rotunda on Stan Lane. Oh, they move quick. Very fast, very agile. All four of them here. Stan Lane looked like he went to tag off, wanted to tag off. He reached his arm out, and he was looking at blonde hair, and he thought that it might be Steve Kearn. And who was it but Barry Wyndham? Wyndham now with an arm bar on Lane. Lane thinking, moving, maneuvering all the time. Look at that back heel. Maiawashi leg kick. Shoulder block by Stan Lane. Down goes Wyndham. Across goes Lane. Again. Oh, what an arm drag. What an arm drag takedown there by Barry Wyndham. That takes absolutely only the most demanding of timing. Again, an arm drag takedown following the tag. Wyndham on Steve Kearns. Kearns now is backed into the corner. And the tag off. Mike Rotunda in. Kearn backs out. Kearn coming now back into the ring as the count had reached five by referee Buddy Lane. Rotunda and Wyndham, an excellent, excellent tag team combination. But the same must be said for Lane and Kearns, the fabulous ones. They exchanged forearm smashes, and it was Steve Kearns who came out the worst for wear. Rotunda, 250 pounds out of Sweetwater, Texas. Side headlock by Rotunda. Grinds it away. Tried to push him off. Kearns tried to whip him to the other side, but Rotunda just maintained that side headlock, as he does again. Kearns can't get rid of him. Kearns now trying to power his way out. Rotunda still with the advantage, but Kearns working it up. Kearns had a hold of the hair of Rotunda, and referee Buddy Lane broke that up. And that allowed Rotunda to get back to the side headlock. Rotunda was tagged in Barry Wyndham. And it's understandable how these two people were at one time the tag team champions of the world in the WWF. They are exceptionally fine wrestlers. They are very, very quick. Their timing is exact. Great condition. One knows what the other is doing at all times. Hard shoulder block again. Wyndham. Down goes Kearns. Kearns comes up. I think he wanted to put probably just a leapfrog over Rotunda, but Rotunda saw that coming, and he caught Kearns flush in the air with a shot to the midsection. And you saw the body slam. Rotunda, or rather Wyndham, in control, tags in Rotunda, and here is the double flying drop kick. Kearns didn't get it all. He did catch some of the rope as he was coming off, but he got enough of it, of the double flying drop kick, where it really, really hurt him. Kearns looking for Lane, but he's not in the direction in which he was looking.
Come on, referee.
And Mike Rotunda. Chin lock here. Rotunda with the Irish whip. Kearns got out of the way, and Rotunda went banging into that turnbuckle with his shoulder, with that left shoulder and arm. Steve Kearns, sensing he has his man in trouble, now goes to work on the eyes. Steve Kearns and Stan Lane have come up with a few tactics that we hadn't seen them use before. But they are in against a couple of bigger men, and there was a karate shot to the throat by Stan Lane after the tag, and a back heel kick again by Stan Lane. An Irish whip by Lane. Ooh, he caught Rotunda coming off the ropes, flush into the midsection, and now Lane bringing Rotunda to the corner. Kearns caught him with a knee, but then Rotunda catches Kearns after the tag, and Kearns rakes his fingernails across the back of Mike Rotunda. The action fast and furious, hot and heavy. Now Steve Kearns biting on Mike Rotunda directly in front of us. Kearns now tags in Stan Lane as the Fabulous Ones have taken the play away from the former WWF champions. In, however, very quickly comes Barry Wyndham to aid his tag team partner, Mike Rotunda. Rotunda is sent sprawling outside of the ring. Barry Wyndham going over to check on his partner. It is Stan Lane in the ring, taking a shoulder block from Rotunda. Up and over the sunset flip. No, he can't work it. He couldn't get it going, but it looked like Rotunda may have had Lane in deep, deep trouble. Lane takes him to the corner, to the turnbuckle. Kearn is checked in. Front face lock here by Kearn. Rotunda trying to back Kearn across the ring over toward Barry Wyndham and get a tag off. Steve Kearn distracting the referee, Buddy Lane. And now there has been no tag. Lane and Kearn both working on Rotunda. It is Kearn with a knee lift to the midsection. And now the front face lock here and the neck breaker here by Stan Lane. Lane trying to finish off Mike Rotunda. Rotunda rolls away from an elbow smash. In comes Barry Wyndham and plants a right hand squarely. And again, another right hand squarely on Lane. And now on Kearn. And now the head knocker. And both Lane and Kearn deposited to the canvas. An elbow smash by Wyndham. First on Kearn, and now he goes to work on Lane. The whip across and the power body slam, as it is Wyndham covering Lane, but he got only a two count. Steve Kearn bombing Wyndham to the middle of the back. A running headbutt, a crawling headbutt actually, by Stan Lane on Barry Wyndham. Both men are stunned. Lane is up first, and they come to the corner. And Lane tags in Kearns. Rotunda wondering where he is at, what is happening. chin lock, reverse chin lock. Rotunda claiming it as a chokehold. Referee Buddy Lane checking on that. Still with the chin lock, the reverse chin lock is Steve Lane.
10 minutes gone by.
Steve Kearns, rather. Stan Lane outside the ring. Now they tag. Lane is in. Kearns hangs on, and Lane gets the hold. And here is the whip across. Uh-oh, here is the sunset flip. Suddenly, up and over is Lane. Stan Lane, Buddy Lane, the referee, coming over for a count as he was detained over in the corner momentarily by Kearns and Rotunda. Stan Lane looking to pick up his man. Here is a small package with Stan Lane in deep trouble. The referee finally seeing it, coming over in a count of two. Actually, it could have been a count up to 10. Miwashi leg kick now by Stan Lane on Barry Wyndham. Wyndham just about had his man pinned. He had him down there for certainly more than the 3 seconds. And now the two Lanes, one referee, the other, the wrestler, are talking off in a corner. And it was the wrestler, Stan Lane, detaining the referee, Buddy Lane. And in it now is Steve Kearns with a side headlock on Barry Wyndham. Golly, they work fast. All four of them do. Lane and Kearns adopting some more of the roughhouse tactics than what we've seen them use in the past, and fighting away with right hands. Here is Barry Wyndham on Steve Kearns. Kearns goes down and grabs the leg. Lane comes in. Stan Lane on Wyndham, the Irish whip. Wyndham catches Lane waiting. One fall, 30-minute time limit. This tag team match, look at this action. Fast and furious, a shoulder block by Stan Lane, and both he and Barry Wyndham hit the deck. The count is to three on both of them. It's a matter of who can get to his feet first, and Steve Kearns comes in with a boot to the back of the head on Barry Wyndham. Wyndham diving over and makes the tag with Mike Rotunda. Rotunda, the Irish whip. Rotunda, a drop kick on Stan Lane. Rotunda, a hard right hand. Deck Steve Kearns. Rotunda with a whip. An elbow smash by Rotunda on Stan Lane. It's all Mike Rotunda right now, the 242-pounder out of Syracuse, New York. You saw that move by Rotunda. Mike Rotunda. Irish whip on Lane. Uh-oh, here you have the airplane spin. Stan Lane in trouble. Steve Kearns reaches in and catches the feet of Mike Rotunda. And now a quick cover. It looked like it was three, but it was only two, as Stan Lane had the cover on Mike Rotunda. Lane stunned in the center of the ring, takes a hard right hand, fires back with a right hand of his own, and a knee lift of his own by Stan Lane on Mike Rotunda. Steve Kearns comes in, does a bit of damage. Lane continuing to work over Mike Rotunda. The whip by Lane, the back body drop, and down, crashing to the canvas, is Mike Rotunda. Lane trying to set him up for the head knocker or the pile driver, one or the other. Barry Wyndham from the top rope comes crashing down on Lane, hooks the leg, covers him. One, two, and three. We were looking directly into the eyes of Stan Lane. He did not know where he was. He was out of it just long enough for the three count, and it was Barry Wyndham on the hook of the leg and the cover and getting the three count over Stan Lane, and the victory goes to the former WWF Kingpins, Mike Rotunda and Barry Wyndham. And we're going to get a chance to take another look at that, you and I, and here it is. You see Wyndham coming across and catching Lane with an elbow smash to the back of the head, coming over, hooking the leg, and now the count of one and two and three, and Stan Lane was actually out of it for a matter of seconds, But those seconds were precious, and the count went to three for Rotunda and Wyndham.
And the time of the match, 14 minutes, 1 second. The winners, the team of Barry, Wyndham, and Mike.